So right now I'm at Dollar Tree and this is the stuff I found. They have a really good selection of like flowers if you're one of those extravagant gals. You need to like make your tree really crazy. We're gonna do some Christmas activities together, guys. So I'm kind of having a problem because I don't know whether I want to get this silver or this rose gold to go with like the pink frosty gold thing. I wish y'all were here in real life to help me because like this is kind of hard. Ended up getting both. I asked some people to help me choose and they said give both.
This is my teeny tiny little tree. She's 4 feet.
I want to show y'all everything.
Cedar picks, and they're like these poinsettias, eucalyptus white poinsettias, rose gold poinsettias, rose gold pinkish silver iridescent tinsel garland, a ballerina, it's a beautiful snowflake, a freaking unicorn, this beautiful pearl tree, these bells, of course, another beautiful ballerina. These are perfect. Like, I got another one just like that. Cuties. Look at it. That ornament's evil twin right here. You see, I tried my best to kind of coordinate. Super cute. It's shimmery and it's pink.
Okay, so for anyone that shops thrifty, you know that when you buy a little bit cheaper, sometimes requires more work. And that was no different than with these Dollar Tree ornaments. And so I was threading them myself and it was kind of difficult because I had to cut the string in half because my silver pack didn't come with any at all. And so anytime you see my cheeks go up, I wanted to scream.
I got all the ornaments on there that came in the 12-pack packages.
Closer looks.
This is what she's looking like so far. Do you see the shimmer, shimmer, shine, shine? This is how it looks with the flowers added. I think this is so cool. And we have the tree topper. And we just place it on top. This is literally one of the most perfect things I've ever created. I literally am so in love with it. I hope y'all like it. I hope this gave you some inspiration. You can go to Dollar Tree. This is all from Dollar Tree. Hey y'all, so I'm about to do a little Christmas activity just to get into the holiday spirit because I actually hate the holidays a lot. Oh, it's so cute and tiny. So this is the icing board. I'm gonna have such a time with this. These are all the houses. There are 4 cookies in here. And then the decorations. And I did bring some additional decorations just to make sure that I'm giving my gingerbread village the beauty and architecture that it deserves. I'm cutting out the middleman and I'm not putting this into this icing bag that's in here. I'm just gonna cut a little strip in the bag and call it a day with that one because I already know that's a mess waiting to happen and I simply do not want to see what that looks like. The instructions for it are on the back of the box.
Those are all the decorations. These are the 2 cookie houses. These are the other 2 villages.
First thing that I'm gonna do is assemble the houses. I feel like that's a great first step to take. And so on the back it says to make sure not to mix up the cookie pieces. Oh, that scared me. So let me cut this house up first. Let me jump in like I don't know how to chop stuff. First house that I'm gonna bake is one of the classic cottages. It has 6 pieces to it. I hope that's funny enough. Okay. I feel like I'm doing something serious. So I found a real crafty way to do this because I'm a crafty gal. It's just better to like use your fingers with the icing because this icing is actually very sticky. I completed my first gingerbread house. I don't know how long this shit's gonna stay together. I'm putting it on the top, bottom, and the sides to help it stick. Okay, y'all, so I figured out what I did wrong with the other house, because this house seems unshakable. We'll see, because I won't speak too soon and then it starts crumbling and crackling. But I built this house wrong, and I knew I was building it wrong when I started. I just wanted to keep going because I was trying to be tenacious, but in reality, you have to do it right for it to be like, for it to be functional. So let's start again. Like I said, I prefer fingers. I know this is a little bit more messy, but the girls that are really about being Bobina the Builders are gonna get it. Like I did before, I'm gonna ice all the sides this time, like I did with the second house. So you have to connect it on the inside instead of like on the outside, okay? That's the big tip and the thing that I did not do. That's where my big mistake was. Why are you seeing how I slipped that in there? This is prime architecture, babe. My villages are complete. Aren't y'all pretty? This is pretty impressive. So, first things first, I want to taste everything. So, I'm going to take one of these and. It's disgusting as fuck. I had a green thing, I'm going to this white thing. I'm not tasting shit else. Just real quick. These are called classic cottages, but one is bigger than the other one. That's the first thing. Then second thing is, why is this one called a colonial house? Interesting. And then this one is called A-frame house. Beam over here, and then the colors over here. So first things first is I'm gonna put this on the roof, because I know that I'm about to line the roof with green and red flowers. And then in between the flowers, I'm going to put a little pearl, or one of the little, like a couple of little sprinkles. Yes. So then I'm gonna just take some of these sprinkles and just like, so that did not do at all what I wanted it to. So let's pretend like that didn't happen. I'm gonna put the gumdrop on the windows, because it ain't like nobody looking out of them. It's cookie. Can't really access this side of the house, so I'm gonna just do a little something on this right here. Like I told y'all, this is a pretty messy type vibe, so.
And the main house is a super festive one. The stuff keeps coming off, but I had to make the driveways and the sidewalk look really cute. So there's this one. My faves are these two. We have our all white house and our red and white house. And I think these look so good.
Be a real motherfucking Christmas vibe if we didn't have the Christmas snacks.
We're gonna make some s'mores. I've never made s'mores with cookies and cream before, but I'm super excited to try it because I feel like it would be delicious. Cookies and cream is my favorite type of Hershey's, and I'm gonna eat a couple of these cookies, and then I have some other Christmas cookies that don't have to be baked. And I'm gonna make a little holiday
charcuterie board.
I think I'm gonna make some chai. Y'all love me a good chai. It's just an assortment of different Christmas snacks. I know this is such a bad angle, but this cookies and cream s'more, the best thing I ever put in my mouth. The original one's really good too, I will never eat s'mores the same way again. That cookies and cream s'more, from now on, it's always gonna be made that way. Thank you so much for watching my video, and I hope that you enjoyed all the festive activities. See y'all in the next video. Bye.